very important for us to realize what's at stake here. This pipeline is not going to bring more jobs to our country. It's not going to bring more safety to our country.
The Keystone Pipeline is going to worsen the climate change crisis, and it's also going to devastate nature and ecosystems. And I think that's a bad idea.
Tar sands, no way, not ever, not today. Tar sands, no way, not ever, not today.
Starting today, the voice of America shall be heard. The conscience of America shall be felt. What do we want? A Robin Hood tax.
I work at the Institute for Policy Studies. We're a progressive think tank that's about turning ideas into action, just like y'all are doing right now. Unless we take the climate fight seriously and we put Robin Hood tax revenue into green jobs, into making our communities climate resilient, into a clean energy revolution, we're gonna lose the fight against climate change. So let's tell Congress, the White House, we need a Robin Hood tax now to help us fight climate change.
Bolivia's own regulations show promising signs of progress in controlling coca leaf production. So was President Evo Morales right to kick out the U.S. Drug Enforcement Administration?
If you want someone to stop doing something, it's important to understand why they're doing it to begin with. And previous models and other forced eradication models around the world treat these farmers growing illicit crops as mere criminals. Just stop what you're doing. But in fact, they're family farmers. And if you don't understand why they're growing these crops year after year, you do forced eradication, and you force these families into food insecurity.
We're joined now by Phyllis Bennis, fellow at the Institute for Policy Studies. She's written a number of books, including Challenging Empire, How People, Governments, and the UN Defy U.S. Power. Her new piece in the Nation magazine blog is entitled Moral Obscenities in Syria. Phyllis, welcome back to Democracy Now!
The United Nations Charter, which is the fundamental component of international law governing issues of war and peace, is very, very clear on what constitutes the legal use of military force.
Is there a system that might achieve democracy, equality, liberty, community, ecological sustainability, and not destroy the planet with climate change problems? And what in the world is a system?
It's amazing to think back 50 years to 1963, when two young men, Mark Raskin and Dick Barnett, both under 30 years old, were working in the Kennedy administration, saw the limitations of how policy was made and how power worked in that setting. They left and created the Institute for Policy Studies.
I think that there are a lot of elements that make the Institute for Policy Studies different from other organizations. We don't take government money. We take on issues that are both domestic and international. We have a theory of social change that combines social movements and strong analysis.
Public scholarship is an attempt to use the principles of scholarship in a way that engages the real world with a view to achieving change, not simply to report.
At IPS, we try to combine scholarship with activism to make social change. And that means not only doing the research and the analysis and the framing, but also figuring out where you can get traction.
We really emphasize making sure we're connecting our analysis with our allies in other parts of the world.
We are working on ending the drug war, making sure there isn't outrageous CEO pay. You know, little things like saving the planet.
What's your job? My job is changing the world. That's what we try to do at IPS.
This is one of the things I've learned at IPS. First of all, you need a good idea about what the world should be, which helps people contrast what the world actually is. And it shows folks that you could have a better world, right? A brighter future. I think that's how change happens, once people coalesce around a good idea.